Next, the structure of angiospermic plants. Okay, generally we know that guys, the flower is their reproductive organ. So generally, they flower. We talk about the structure of the flower. Okay, so all the angiospermic plant has a flower. So these flower just look like that. It is a 3D diagram of the flower which show the pistil, the female reproductive organ, and the stamen, a male reproductive organ. Okay. Okay. A solon part, a sepalus, a petals. Okay, and the ovary, and these are the stamen. Okay, so structurally, if we talk about the structure of the angiospermic plant, the angiospermic plant has a stalk. So these are the stalk. Okay, thread. You can see the rough structure, yeah, a part of the stem which provide the attachment. Okay, and even provide the nourishment. Okay, and they get nourishment from the lower part of the plant body. Okay, these are the thalamus. Okay, these are the thalamus portion, a portion which provide the base for the reproductive part of the flower. Okay, next, these are the sepals. Okay, these are sepal, which is known as calyx. Scientifically, they are known as calyx. Okay, a portion will provide the protection for the attractive unit, which is the attractive unit, a petal. Okay, these are the sepals. These are the petals. Pankhudi, jisko bolte ho aap log, petals, which is also known as the corolla. Okay, a portion which is known as the attractive unit of the flower and has the ability to attract the pollinating agent. Pollinating agents are those which transfer male gametes from the male reproductive organ to the female reproductive organ. Okay, they are very colorful portion of the flower. Okay, or these are the greenish portion of the flower. These are the brownish portion of the flower. Okay, next we have a male reproductive organ. These are the stamen. Okay, stamen ka just diagram is just like that. Okay, these are the anther. Okay, or the filament. ठीक है, फ्लामेंट है, दीज आर नोन एज द कनेक्टिवा. ओके, तो दीज आर द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन, अ स्टैमेन विच हैज थ्री पार्ट, एंथर, कनेक्टिवा एंड फ्लामेंट. ओके, एंड दीज सोलोन पार्ट लाइक दैट, दीज आर द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन विच इज नोन एज द कार्पेल. ओके, एंड कार्पेल हैज three another part. Let me read these thing. A stigma, a portion which provide the attachment site for male reproductive system. A style, a portion which provide the pathway to transfer the male reproductive organ, male reproductive gamete to the female gametes. Okay, and these are the ovary, inside which seed are produced, inside which double fertilization are there, occur. Okay, so these are the part of carpel or pistil. Clear? So here we can see that the male sex organ in the flower is a stamen. We know that the diagram just like that. Okay, each stamen consists of the slender filament with an anther at the tip. These are the anther and these are the filament. Filament help anther to attach with the stamen, to attach with the portion of the flower. okay, the anther flowering following the meiosis, and they produce a pollen grains. Okay, anther produce pollen grains, or we know that pollen grains are the male gametes of angiospermic plants. Okay, next, the female sex organ is a flower which is the pistil or the carpel. Already discussed these things. Okay, pistil consists of ovary enclosed one to many ovules. Inside the ovary there are the many ovules are there, just like that. Okay, within the ovules present highly reduced female gametophyte termed as embryo sac. These inside portion is अच्छे से draw कर लेते हैं इसको. Okay, these are the ovary. These are the ovule. Inside this, embryo sacs are present. Embryo sac. Okay. The embryo sac formation proceed by meiosis cell division. Okay. Both do the meiosis cell division. Hence, each of called embryo sac is haploid. So we can say that are the haploid in nature. Haploid n number of chromosome, only half number of chromosomes are there, is known as chromosomes, is known as haploid condition. Okay, the embryo sac formation preceded by the meiosis, a reductional division. That is why gametes are always haploid in nature. Okay, jo gametes produce hote hain, they are always haploid in nature. They only have a half number of their chromosome. Each embryo cell has three cell egg apparatus. Okay, अब लाइक आपको यहाँ देखना होगा, ये इस तरीके का एक डायग्राम होता है एम्ब्रियो सेक के अंदर. ओके, दीज आर द एनलार्ज व्यू ऑफ एम्ब्रियो. दीज आर द एम्ब्रियो सेक. ओके, इनसाइड द एम्ब्रियो सेक there are the three cells are there, which is known as the antipodal cell, a cell which give rise the nourishment of whole embryo. Okay, next, in the center of the cell, these are the some fused cell which is known as polar nuclei. Kya kaha jata hai? Polar nuclei. Okay, and here these are the cushion like structure which is known as the filiform apparatus. Okay, on the upper side of the filiform apparatus, these are the two cells are there, and these two cells are known as the synergid. Okay, a cell which provide the nourishment and nutrition for the egg cell. Okay, and these are the egg cell. Okay, so they are the seven celled eight nucleate structure found in the angiospermic plant. Seven celled, 1, 2, 3, 4 as whole count ki jati, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so they are the seven celled eight nucleate. Why? Because inside these seven cell, each cell has the nucleus. So one nucleus, two nucleus, three nucleus. Yeah, polar nucleus is counted as a one cell, but they has a two nucleus. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 nucleus. Okay, so clear why angiospermic plant is too unique, because they show the very unique structure where the seven celled eight nucleus structure are shown, and these seven celled eight nucleus structure participate in the double fertilization. Clear? Let me raise these things. We know that when the plants do the double fertilization, so double fertilization plants, या female ovary required a two male gametes. Okay, ये चीजें हम लोग पढ़े हैं पहली tenth में. Okay, here we can see that these are the embryo and these are the egg or the polar nuclei. When the first male gametes fuse with the female gametes, so they form a zygote. A first fertilization. Okay. Or when the second male gamete fuse with the second male gametes, fuse with the polar nuclei, so they form a endosperm. Okay. Or these are the second fertilization. Okay. So. जी हो गया ना दो फर्टिलाइजेशन, अ फर्स्ट फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड द सेकंड फर्टिलाइजेशन, दैट इज व्हाई दे डू द डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन. ओके, दीज एंडोस्पर्म हेल्प टू नरिश द होल फ्रूट और दीज आर द जायगोट वेयर द सीड्स आर प्रोड्यूस. सिंपल. ओके, सो फॉर दैट कंडीशन प्लांट रिक्वायर द पॉलिनेटिंग एजेंट बिकॉज they require the pollen grain for fusion, so they transfer pollen grain from the anther portion to stigmatic portion, or these transformation process is known as the pollination. There are the two types, self pollination and the cross pollination. Clear? Okay, next thing related to the these endosperm beta, okay, sperm, it is known as the pen. अब प्राइमरी एंडोस्पर्म न्यूक्लियस, और ये किससे फॉर्म हुआ है, पोलर न्यूक्लियाई का फ्यूजन हुआ किससे, अ सेकेंडरी मेल गैमेट से. ओके, हियर यू कैन सी दैट द अदर मेल गैमेट फ्यूज विद द डिप्लॉइड न्यूक्लियस टू प्रोड्यूस अ ट्रिप्लॉइड प्राइमरी एंडोस्पर्म न्यूक्लियस, एंड दीज पैन इज अ ट्रिप्लॉइड इन नेचर. अब पूछो व्हाई मैम दे आर ट्रिप्लॉइड इन नेचर, बिकॉज पोलर न्यूक्लियाई हैज टू न्यूक्लियस. ओके, polar nuclei just like that na have two nucleus and the male gametes have one nucleus. When these three nucleus fuse together, to say they form a 3n number of cell, that is why these are the triploid in nature. Okay, and when fertilization by which zygote is formed and the triple fusion by which endosperm is formed और अगर इनसाइड द फ्लावर, तो दे शो द डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन. क्लियर? तो दीज आर द यूनिक प्रोसेस विच इज सीन इन द एंजियोस्पर्मिक प्लांट्स. ओके, हियर इन दिस पिक यू कैन इजीली अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन इन विच अ एग सेल एंड द पोलर न्यूक्लियाई फ्यूज विद द sperm cell, yeah, we can say that the pollen grains. Okay, to understand these thing, here these are the AHW question. Okay, answer all these question in your notebook along with the date, and if possible to draw the diagram of monocot and dicot seeds. Aaj ke liye itna enough hai. In the next class, we will discuss about the another things related to the angiospermic. Hope all these things clear to you. If it is not clear, so you can message me. I always there to help you. Okay? Thank you.